This is such a sad story. An off-duty firefighter in Rio de Janeiro slapped a McDonald's drive-thru worker and then proceeded to burst into the restaurant and shoot the employee over a discount coupon, according to the allegation. Let's put up one of the surveillance photos here. In surveillance footage, a man identified as Sergeant Paulo Albuquerque was filmed speaking to the McDonald's employee, all right? 21 years of age, the employee. This was through a drive-thru window May 9th. The sergeant is seen getting out of his car and decided to strike the worker. The worker returns the favor and jabs him. Okay, natural response, self-defense. No issue there. Sergeant Albuquerque then proceeded to enter the restaurant with a handgun. That's him going into the restaurant. He then went to the back and shot the employee. The sergeant shot the employee from point blank range before he allegedly fled the scene, all over a McDonald's coupon. The firefighter had apparently placed an order at the drive-thru window, but only said he was entitled to a discount when it was time to pay, and not at the beginning of the order as the coupon's terms and conditions demand. The young man was taken to the hospital for injuries. He needed surgery for the gunshot wound to his stomach and had to have his left kidney removed. At the time of the reporting of this, he was still hospitalized, but is in stable condition, thankfully. The sergeant turned himself in on Monday afternoon. His lawyers arguing that his firearm and it discharged by accident. So they're saying, oh, no, this was not intentional. This was all just a big misunderstanding, and his firearm just shot itself. It just went off all on his own. That's the defense, all right? As a matter of fact, I'm glad this guy has such a dumbass for an attorney. Keep him, please. The fire department has since suspended the sergeant, his license to carry, and has launched an internal inquiry into his conduct. All right, so Dina Dahl, you are an attorney extraordinaire, great legal mind. I could think of a better defense than this one to say, well, you know, the gun just accidentally went off. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, I think the problem is it's hard, and he's on tape, and there's obviously no self-defense claim that he could have. So he doesn't have a good defense, and he probably should just be pleading guilty and trying to hope that maybe he can have a lighter sentence. I mean, I think this is kind of like a theme that we've had on this show, is like how dangerous guns are, and especially in the hands of, you know, somebody like him who's angry. That's all of these people are. They're angry for some reason or another. And our decision in 2008, the Heller decision by the Supreme Court that made us have a personal right to have guns in this country was judicial activism that should be reversed. There's absolutely no reason. It's not written that way in our Constitution. And until that happens, gun violence is going to increase here.
That's actually very well said. It's an unfortunate reality, but you presented it correctly.